One of the most well-known predictions in Catholic history is the prophecy of the popes and antipopes that is attributed to St. Malachy. St. Malachy was a Catholic bishop born in 1094 in Ireland. He died in the presence of his good friend St. Bernard in 1148. St. Bernard said that St. Malachy foretold the day and hour of his own death. St. Malachy was canonized in 1190, and a reading for his feast day mentions that he was blessed with the gift of prophecy. According to the 1913 Catholic Encyclopedia under the title of Prophecy, it says that St. Malachy was called to Rome in 1139 by Pope Innocent II. While in Rome, it is reported that St. Malachy experienced a vision of future claimants to the papacy till the second coming of Jesus Christ. St. Malachy wrote 112 short Latin phrases describing all these future claimants to the papacy, giving titles to both popes and antipopes. The document was then reportedly placed in the Vatican's secret archives and wasn't discovered until 1556 by a Vatican librarian. The document was first published 39 years later in 1595 by historian Arnold de Wyon in a book called Tree of Life. De Wyon was assisted in his translation of the document by Alfonso Chacon, a well-known scholar of medieval manuscripts. Chacon was given the job of authenticating the document and making sure it wasn't a forgery. After examining the document, Chacon verified it as authentic. While God apparently showed St. Malachy the different men who in the future would claim to be the leaders of the Catholic Church, he did not necessarily reveal to St. Malachy whether these future claimants to the papacy were good or evil, and he did not reveal to him whether they were true popes or antipopes. St. Malachy was simply shown the men who until the end of human history would present themselves to the world as the leaders of the Catholic Church. Furthermore, as humanity moved closer and closer to the end of the world, God wanted people in the last days to have some idea how close they were to the second coming of Christ. St. Malachy's descriptions of future claimants to the papacy usually include at least one or more of the following things concerning the claimant: his coat of arms, his family's coat of arms, his birth name or birthplace, or cities in which he would live during his life. St. Malachy also described major figures or events that would overshadow the reigns of some of the claimants to the papacy. As mentioned earlier, the prophecies of St. Malachy were published for the first time in 1595. There is a controversy over St. Malachy's pre-1595 predictions. Many believe that since St. Malachy's list was only publicly available for the first time in 1595, the predictions referring to pre-1595 claimants constitute no proof of authenticity. Moreover, some believe that since St. Malachy's prophecy wasn't publicly released until hundreds of years after it was reportedly first made, doubt exists about the entire prophecy, since there is controversy over the St. Malachy prophecies before 1595. We will not consider any examples of his predictions that concern papal claimants before 1595, but only those after 1595. St. Malachy describes Antipope John Paul II as, quote, of the solar eclipse. John Paul II was born on May 18, 1920, the day of a solar eclipse. On the day of John Paul II's funeral, April 8, 2005, there was also an eclipse of the sun. This is a striking fulfillment of St. Malachy's prophecy. On September 19, 1846, the Blessed Virgin Mary appeared to two little children at La Salette, France, and predicted that, quote, Rome will lose the faith and become the seat of the Antichrist. The Church will be in eclipse. Our Lady predicted that outside a remnant of Catholics who will preserve the true faith, most people will not see or find real Catholicism because, for one reason, the Church will seem to be dominated, blocked out, or eclipsed by something. That something was John Paul II. He was the eclipse of the Catholic Church. The predictions made by Our Lady at La Salette and Fatima, according to St. Malachy, the final claimant to the papacy in the history of mankind is described as Petrus Romanus, Peter the Roman. St. Malachy says about the last claimant that, quote, in the final persecution of the Holy Roman Church, there will sit Peter the Roman, who will feed the sheep in many tribulations. And when these things are finished, the city of seven hills, Rome, will be destroyed, and the dreadful judge will judge his people. The end. End quote. If St. Malachy's prophecy is correct, Antipope Francis will be the last person in history who will claim to be the Bishop of Rome. Keep in mind that St. Malachy predicted both popes and antipopes, whoever would claim to be the Bishop of Rome. The reason St. Malachy called him Peter the Roman is because St. Peter, as Bishop of Rome and the first pope, had the name Peter, and St. Malachy calls the last man who will claim to be the Bishop of Rome by the same name, Peter. And since Francis, according to St. Malachy's list, is the final claimant to the Roman See before the destruction of Rome, he calls him Peter the Roman. Another reason St. Malachy called Francis the Roman is that Francis has emphasized the title Bishop of Rome in a unique way. Antipope Francis has generally avoided the title of Pope and other titles associated with claimants to the papacy. The official Vatican directory lists a number of different titles for claimants to the papacy, but Francis has rejected all these titles except the one title of Bishop of Rome, which he specifically requested. Francis has stressed in a highly unusual way that he is merely acting as if his authority is limited locally to Rome. In fact, in his very first words after his quote election, Francis explicitly stated that the reason for a conclave was, quote, to give a bishop to Rome. Francis is perhaps the only claimant in history who mentioned the title, quote, Bishop of Rome, in his very first words to the world after his quote election. He was therefore immediately identified with Rome, or in a particular way as a Roman. Quote, it was striking that in his initial appearances he repeatedly referred to himself as the Bishop of Rome, rather than emphasizing his role as an authority figure in the universal church. Also, Francis was the first claimant in history to sign his name in Italian rather than Latin in the Vatican's official directory. Italian is the language of modern Romans, which Francis happens to speak perfectly, whereas Latin is the language of the church throughout the world. This is another example of Francis's emphasis on a particular local or Roman role, instead of a universal one. During a press conference on November 25, 2014, a reporter asked Francis, quote, I wanted to know, when traveling to Strasbourg, whether in your heart you were traveling as Peter's successor, as the Bishop of Rome, or as the Archbishop of Buenos Aires. Francis answers the question by saying, quote, I'm a Roman. Interestingly, Francis chose the name of the most well-known saint of Italy, Saint Francis of Assisi. Assisi is only 2 hours from Rome. During his life, Saint Francis went to Rome, and Saint Francis's middle name and his father's name happens to be Peter. Saint Malachy also says that Peter the Roman will feed people during many tribulations. It is very interesting that while Antipope Francis doesn't care if someone rejects Jesus Christ or the Catholic faith, he does claim to care about physically feeding people in need. On page 129 of his 2010 book, Conversations with Jorge Bergoglio, Francis says the only sin being committed in Argentina is failing to provide food and work for people. He says nothing about sins against God and God's faith. Conversations with Jorge Bergoglio, page 129, quote, it is a problem of sin. For 4 years, Argentina has been living a sinful existence because it has not taken responsibility for those who have no food or work. If tribulations occurred in the world in which people were without food or other necessities, Francis would probably go to extremes to feed those people, and would therefore fulfill what St. Malachy says, he will feed the sheep in many tribulations. We can see that Francis, only a couple of years into his reign as antipope, may have already fulfilled this prophecy. Francis has stressed feeding and helping the homeless like no other papal claimant in history. He has even declared the Sistine Chapel to be the property of the homeless, no matter what their religious beliefs are. Homeless are literally moving to the Vatican to get help from Francis. Non-Catholics who believe in St. Malachy's prophecies yet reject the Roman Catholic Church should deeply consider what St. Malachy says. He refers to the Roman Church, which everyone admits is the Roman Catholic Church, and he calls it, quote, holy. If the Roman Catholic Church were a false church, there would be no way that St. Malachy would describe it as, quote, holy, and only God could have given St. Malachy the ability to make such incredibly accurate predictions about the future. God would not have given such incredible insights about future events to a believer and leader of a false religion. What is also extremely interesting is that St. Malachy describes Rome being destroyed at the end of Francis's reign. If correct, this fits perfectly with the prophecies in the Apocalypse about how Babylon, Rome, is destroyed at the end of the world.
God is not coming to destroy his church, but to save his bride. The fact that the church system is being destroyed, and that their own apparitions of Mary's state, Rome, the city on seven hills, is the seat of Antichrist, that should make you think twice. Now, if you're a Roman Catholic, you should really seriously reflect on that. A better authority than Malachy. Let's look at Holy Scriptures. Revelation 17 identifies the harlot church of Antichrist. Revelation 18 details God's judgment upon her. And Revelation 19 declares the hosts of heaven praising her destruction. And after these things, I heard a great voice of much people in heaven saying, Alleluia, salvation and glory and honor and power unto the Lord our God, for true and righteous are his judgments, for he hath judged the great whore, which did corrupt the earth with her fornication, and hath avenged the blood of his servants at her hand. And again they said, Alleluia, and her smoke rose up forever and ever. Please subscribe and follow the links I provided during this video. May God continue to bless and guide your studies.